Now we're live. Woo! Welcome to Churchill Dance Hall. Thank you all for being here. We're really excited for tonight's show, and I'm glad you're all here with us. Those of you who are here in person and those that are watching from wherever you are on the internet, which is great. We're glad to have you here too. Remember to subscribe. It will be great for us and the musicians that we have perform here once we get to that magic 1,000 subscribers on YouTube, because then we can start paying everybody royalties from the things that we do on this stage, which would be great. So a big thank you to Mr. Lauren Joseph, our sound and lighting engineer. We have all of these new lights here. A big thank you to also Abby Dennis for Millie, the octopus that's behind us. So tonight's show is sort of the culmination of something that started last September. During the pandemic, which obviously we're still in, hence the masks, we had Rob and his band come here to record the Live from Churchill album, and it's available tonight. And so we're really, really jazzed, no pun intended, to have Rob Scheps and the TBA band back here at Churchill. So it's gonna be great to hear all this original music that was recorded here last September, and I'm so glad that you're here to get it. It's funny because there's these people giving me these signals, and I'm not sure if they're wrap it up, Bri, because that's the signal that they use in television. But they were doing like this, which is like football talk for like offsides, I think. So maybe it's like just keep it going, because we really love to hear the sound of your voice, which I really appreciate. So the other projects that we're working on, Lauren, are the windows. And our sound and lighting engineer, Mr. Lauren Joseph and Joseph Millworks, is making us brand new wood windows that are replicas of the original 1925 windows that will replace the vinyl sliders here on the south side of the building. So it's sort of in the rough stages right now. We pulled the boards off to expose the windows, but they're not quite ready because we still need to scrape them. We need to reglaze a whole bunch of them. And then of course we need to paint them and then have the new windows that Lauren creates installed. And it looks like you could give me this sign now, doesn't it? Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rob Scheps and the TBA band.
Celebrate the release of our CD, which is available outside, which is actually called Live at the Churchill School. So yeah, no, you can clap or something, because it's the first CD made in this room. Thank you. You get it? And by the way, our technical advisor and sound engineer this evening and the former mayor of your fair city, Lauren Joseph, right here, he is the audio engineer on said CD, and he did a great job. So we're going to play some music, and then we'll talk to you, okay? So, chameleon bill. Okay, the one chorus up front, right?
What?
The one chorus up front. Yep. Two. I want one, two, three. Thank you. So that opening piece, we turn this mic down a little bit. Just long story short, it's dedicated to all of you multi-creatives here in Baker City, and it's called Chameleonville, which is our nickname as Portlanders for Baker City, Chameleonville. So that's for all of you guys. And now we're gonna play something that's actually on the CD. That isn't, because it was written, right, but the, no, Chameleonville was written in the parking lot while I was waiting for these guys to show up to make the record a year ago, Labor Day of 2020. So anyway, here's one of the tunes from Live at the Churchill School. This is called Green Goddess.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Seems like an opportune tune. Opportune time. Wow, that was a Jewish spoonerism or something. But you know, folks, there you go. See, that's what Rodenkirk missed. Anyway, Catskills in Baker County. Let me introduce this great band to you. This incredible drummer that you just heard makes a living as a jazz pianist, but I needed a really good drum sub, and he's that good. George Colligan from Portland, Oregon. Originally from Baltimore and New York. On the piano over here, my longtime colleague, recently retired from 3,000 years at Eastern Oregon University, and making the most of it, Matt Cooper. Dr. Matt Cooper, sorry. And the way the pandemic worked was we had a concert here, Matt and I, last August 21st, and I realized that I have not been out of Oregon and Washington since then, even though I was supposed to be a lot of places, like many of you, I'm sure. But one of the few advantages of that, aside from coming out here Labor Day weekend, at Corinne Vegter's suggestion, why don't you just make the CD here? I'm really glad she said those words. That's right. Yes, thank you for your opiated early evening applause. We appreciate that. But one thing that's happened is I've gotten to meet some of the newer, younger cats in Portland that I didn't know when I kind of left. And one of the best of them is this bass player, Ross Garlow. And it seems repetitious, but my name's Rob Scheps. Hi. We lost a lot of musicians, a lot of older folks, legends due to COVID, people like Jimmy Merritt, Lee Konitz, and Henry Grimes. I mean, they were in their 80s or 90s, but it was still very painful for all of us to lose these giants of music. And can we close that door, please? Somebody? Anybody? Yeah. Okay. And one of the ones that we lost, although not COVID-related, he was 85, it's a good run, but still, one of our favorite bass players, Gary Peacock. So the next piece, when we put it on the CD, we did dedicate it to Gary, kind of right in the wake of his passing. And we hope you like this piece. It's called Amethyst, my favorite rock. Thank you. right into it. Ready? Producer. Ready? Hurry. Ready?
Thank you. Thank you. One woo is all we need to keep going. That song is actually on the CD, and it's a strange title, but anyway, you can read what you want into it. That's what music and art are for. Nobody's actually supposed to tell you anything. No liner notes. But that song is called Pellucid Redemption, whatever that means to you. Here's a swarthy little number called Valentine. Just in time for, United Nations Day?
It's October 24th. It's a little early. Reminisce.
Thank you.
Thank you. Valentine, that was the abridged version. And what we did last year when we made this CD was we kind of looked around and we saw, well, in spite of COVID, maybe Baker City is a good place to stretch out where we could all actually record as a quartet with masks on this stage, kind of pretty distanced. And we did that thanks to Lauren and everybody here at Churchill School. And what happened is we needed to take a break and we listened to some Ricky Lee Jones and some Steely Dan, and then we came up with Halloween Valentine, a paradox, we know. But that's gonna be on volume 2 of Live at the Churchill School that's coming your way next year. But if you're eager for that, I'm not gonna make a commercial, just pick up a CD. Hopefully you'll like it. And it's got a lot of these songs on it. What's next, fellas? Oh, you know what? We're gonna call an audible. Here's something else from the CD. By the way, the only song on the CD that you will not hear tonight is the funniest one, I'm sorry to say. It's called Clam Bake, and it features Dr. Matt Cooper on the accordion. And we realized if we didn't play this song tonight, Matt wouldn't have to bring the accordion from LeGrand, so we gave him an out. So I hope you're not really disappointed missing Matt playing the accordion on Clam Bake. But the other piece that has a certain snarky thing to it. We hope you will enjoy the composition entitled Stick Pimps. I'll say that without the pop, Stick Pimps. By the way, you guys are like a Japan quality audience. It's so great to hear silence between songs. Wow. And I mean that. That's the highest compliment. There are no better audiences than Japan. Everything starts on time, the money's great, and they know every single song that you're playing, even if nobody ever heard it before. They have the record or the download. Okay, here we go with Stick Pimps. The dance floor is right here.
Stick pips. Actually, I forgot. On the CD, I'm supposed to yell right as the fade starts, stick pips! And I forgot to do my part, so I don't get paid for doubling from the Musicians Union in Union County. I'm sorry, we're in Baker County, right? Okay. Union County's where all the COVID is, right? Not Baker. Okay. All right. I don't know. That's what they tell us in the West. We have no idea. Okay. How about these great musicians? Once again, Matt Cooper's playing piano tonight. Take a bow, Matt. Ross Garlow on the basses. Plural. His first time ever in Baker City playing. I'm sure he's been hiking and swimming and kayaking and snowboarding. That's right. He's been here snowboarding. But it's your first time playing bass here, right?
Yes.
In Baker City. That's right. Ross Garlow. And again, on the drums, he's also a master player of the pocket trumpet. Maybe I'll bring him back sometime and make him do that. But the on drums and cymbals and Catskills interludes back there, that's George Colligan. Okay, we'd like to play a little piece now called Shipwrecked that I wrote a certain number of months ago, which just described one of the ebbs in the vicissitudes of dealing with this pandemic. So you dig, I'm sure. Shipwrecked.
Thank you.
Thank you. Shipwrecked. It's hard to see you guys. Is everybody doing okay out there? You cool? Okay, thank you for coming to hear us play some music tonight. We appreciate it. You know, we've all been kind of starved for community and live music and everything else, so I'd like to personally thank the Vectors and everybody who runs the Churchill School here for doing what they can to safely bring it back. Thanks, guys. Yeah. And another shout out to our intrepid ghostly sound man, Mr. Lauren Joseph. Yeah.
Albert Taylor.
Okay, I was just gonna wham into it, but if we played a piece called Albert Daly and we didn't tell you who that was, I don't know how much sense that would make. So raise your hand if you know who Albert Daly is. The American educational system at work. Albert Daly is one of the greatest pianists in the history of jazz. You probably haven't heard of him. He was 49 when he died. He was one of the first casualties of the AIDS crisis. But he made really great records with Art Blakey. He made a beautiful duo record with Stan Getz. I'm sure you've all heard of him, right? And he plays on one of Freddie Hubbard's greatest records. He was kind of everywhere in the late 60s, 70s, 80s. And he was unbelievable. Albert Daly, D-A-I-L-E-Y. I like his playing so much that I wrote a song and I named it Albert Daly. So I hope he knows. This is for you, Albert. Albert Daly. A 1, 2, 3, a 2, 2. Ha! George Colligan on drums, everybody.
Thanks. Albert Daly.
Here's one of the newest pieces, and this is called Vespertine. Raise your hand if you know what that means. It's not a quiz, but I'm just curious. Anybody? And you know what's really beautiful is I'm looking out at all of you, and as far as I can tell, nobody's got their phones out. Just like the old days. Yeah, George is clapping. That's because he teaches at Portland State. He's used to teaching 26 kids who have their phones out.
But Mr. Colligan, I'm taking notes.
But I'm yeah, we're gonna play just a few more for you and call it an evening, but we're really glad you guys are here with us. And this is a rare thing when you make a CD called Live at the Churchill School and then you get to play that music in the Churchill School. That like never happens. So this is kind of an incredible day for us to do this. So thank you for being with us when we do it. Yeah. voice. Thank you. What do you think? Two more and then you can go home? Does that feel right? Feels about the right length. Yes, no? No? No. See, we have a joke here. So when we made the record, Matt was here, and a great bass player from Portland who wished us well tonight, Laurent Nickel. He wanted to send his greetings to everybody. And a 19-year-old drummer named Michael Rodenkirk. I didn't know he was 19 when I hired him, or I might not have hired him, but he's that good. He's from Lake Oswego, Oregon, on the other side of the state, outside of Portland. For me, being Jewish and being partly from New York, although I am an Oregon native born and very proud of it, the only one in my family, no one else can lay claim to it. So I get all the gold. But anyway, he didn't know how to go ba-dump bump on the drums, you know, which is kind of a failing for a professional drummer.
It takes years.
It takes years, right. So that's why, you know, George, when something goes down, he knows to say, right. Anyway. Or it's, you know, like Henny Youngman, take my wife, please. If you're old enough to remember Henny Youngman, you probably shouldn't be here tonight. But see, that's what Mike did. He missed it. But anyway, we were trying to school him. So again, before this whole crap started for everybody in the world, we had a concert here last, I think March 7th of 2020, where we played the music of Pharoah Sanders, and that was a really special, cool concert. But I got into town the night before, and I flipped open my computer, and I found out that McCoy Tyner had passed away. And that's just awful. Just one of my favorite musicians in life, not just pianists. And it was really pretty heavy for me, but unfortunately, visually, I will always remember that I was here in this building when I found out McCoy died. Sorry, guys. And I really wanted to write a piece for him because his music has meant so much to me since, you know, as long as I can remember. And about 6 months later, I was finally able to do it. So we hope you enjoy this tribute to McCoy Tyner called McCoy's, and also it's the view out back there, McCoy's Luminous Mountains.
Thank you.
That's for you, McCoy. Thank you. McCoy's Luminous Mountains, which is actually the last song on the CD, because my internal voice edits for you and says, what the F could follow that? But we have an answer. And it's kind of rough to play on the 20th anniversary of 9/11. That's all I'm going to say about that. It's a rough day for a lot of people. So we're just simply going to send you home with a lament, implorement, beseechment, demand for peace. I wrote it, I can call it what I want. Anyway, the name of this song, and this was written after someone else died, everybody died last year except us, except the people in this room. So the name of the song is, What the World Needs Now is John Lewis. And I want to say once again, these great musicians, everybody drove like maniacs. We were supposed to play in Le Grand tomorrow, but it got postponed because of some COVID concerns. So I just want to say they came all the way out from basically from Portland to do this with you and for you. So special thanks to them. Great musicians. Ross Garlow on bass. Once again, George Colligan on the drums. And Professor Dr. Matt Cooper on the acoustic piano. A very good piano, by the way. And yours truly, my name is Rob Scheps, you guys. Thank you. All right, we're going to send you home with John Lewis. And when we play it, you'll see why this is how we're taking you out, which sounds like we're going to kill you, which we're not. We weren't planning on that. Anyway, great to be back at the Churchill School. And as Nathan Breedlove says in Seattle, love, love. What the world needs now. Thank you. I think that's it for us, guys. Matt Cooper, Ross Garlow, George Carligan, Rob Scheps, TBA Band, live at the Churchill School, actually live! Good night.